Mehmet Oz is a snake oil salesman, an embarrassment to the medical profession, and is using his in-law's Pennsylvania address in order to run for Senate in a state where he does not live. And it gets so much worse. I will explain for the smart people. If you're an idiot, feel free to stop watching and just mash your keyboard a bunch in the comments. But first, the backstory that makes Dr. Oz look a lot more like Doc Ock, which is weird because he physically looks like the Green Goblin. Dr. Oz is actually a doctor, a former cardiothoracic surgeon. That's the specialty of the heart and lungs, one of which I think he has. And despite Oz's attempt to appeal to rural Pennsylvania as a man of the people, he is very much not. Oz was born to a wealthy family and went to a very expensive private preparatory school in Delaware called Tower Hill. Why does the name of that school sound familiar? Tower Hill's president and admissions director were both arrested on charges of child pornography in separate cases. Well, Oz excelled at Tower Hill before attending Harvard undergrad and getting his medical and business degree simultaneously from UPenn. A true man of the people, a wealthy kid who played water polo at Harvard and then attended Wharton. But so far, seems like a bright young doctor, right? Wrong. Oz was a publicity-seeking fraud from the moment he got on his glider. Oz's first job in the medical field was at New York Presbyterian, where Oz founded the Cardiac Complementary Care Center in order to provide patients with alternative medicine. Remember that. It'll come up later. Also, it would have been a little too on the nose to name it Ozcorp. During the 1996 World Series, fortune favored Mehmet Oz. Frank Torrey, brother of then-Yankees manager Joe Torrey, needed heart surgery. The surgery was successful. So when the Yankees came back and won the World Series, Mehmet Oz got a ton of publicity, while the other doctors involved in the procedure did not court the media. Hospital administrators, his fellow doctors, and even the co-founder of Oz's Alternative Medicine Center all complained that Oz's love of attention was getting in the way of their work. His co-founder even went as far as to tell him to, quote, stop the media circus. But you can't tell a TV doctor to stop being a TV doctor. A need for publicity is what makes Mehmet Oz who he is. Well, publicity and pushing fraudulent claims in exchange for money. Oz's medical career led to a professorship at Columbia University, where, in 2015, more than 1,300 doctors demanded that Columbia remove him from the faculty. Why? For what they called disdain for science and evidence-based medicine. While Columbia didn't fire him, Oz is no longer a professor, and no longer sees patients. That's right, the medical industry, just like rational voters, has no patience for him. So when did Oz start pushing his disdain for science toward a widespread audience? Oz became a medical expert on the Oprah Winfrey Show, and eventually, Oprah spun him off into his own syndicated series. Through that fame, Oz hosted a regular radio segment, wrote a column for Esquire, had his own bi-monthly magazine deal with Hearst, and even guest-hosted Jeopardy! Ironically, a show about facts. And all the while, Oz has been racking up fraud claims like they were exploding pumpkins. A 2014 study in the British Medical Journal analyzed 40 episodes of Oz's show. They found that 15% of Oz's claims were refuted with evidence, and another 39% were completely unsubstantiated. That's right, on a medical program hosted by a doctor, more than half of everything he said either had no science behind it or was outright wrong. What were some of the wilder unfounded claims? That apple juice has unsafe levels of arsenic, that cell phones cause breast cancer, and that after you stop taking medication, the spirit of the medication is still there working. Frankly, I'm surprised they didn't do a segment on the love child that Elvis Presley had with Bigfoot. The number one miracle in a bottle to burn your fat. That's what Oz said about raspberry ketones. A way to reveal a great deal about our health. That's what Oz said about astrological signs. And the magic weight loss cure. Oz said that talking about green coffee extract. But Oz didn't just make up these claims. No, he was repeating garbage pseudoscience that he heard elsewhere. The company that funded the green coffee study that Oz quoted, they were fined $3.5 million by the FTC for hopelessly flawed methodology. And there were more claims than that, that lavender soap relieves leg cramps. Or, when talking about Kolobo root extract, Oz said it's been incredibly effective at relieving cold symptoms. Both of those claims are somewhere between gross exaggeration and outright lie. Also in 2014, a Senate hearing was convened on consumer protection because of people like Mehmet Oz. Oz was singled out for how often his unsubstantiated claims are used by weight loss scammers. And Senator Claire McCaskill went as far as to say, "The scientific community is almost monolithic against you." That's right, the Senate held hearings about how much of a fraud Mehmet Oz is. What better way to prevent the Senate from holding hearings like that than to become a senator? Perhaps most egregious is Oz's involvement with RealAge, a website that pushes pharmaceuticals from their sponsors on people seeking actual medical advice. The site makes a ton of money, and is backed by Hearst. I wonder how Oz landed that sweet magazine deal. With Hearst. Real age is widely disregarded in the medical industry, so much so that the American Dental Association withdrew all involvement, and their president called it the promotion of misleading information. But that didn't stop Oz. During the pandemic, Oz's desire for attention over dispensing actual medical advice got even worse. Oz gave platforms to anti-vaxxers and advocated opening schools early for a horrific reason. This is 100% real. Oz said that his opinion was influenced by a study that said, quote, "The opening of schools may only cost us 2-3% in terms of total mortality." That is a direct quote from Oz. He promoted opening schools early because he thought it would only kill 1.5 million American children. But if that's not enough, get ready for watching his politics change depending on who's giving him money. Throughout most of his adult life, Oz has been a vocal Republican, supporting many local politicians in the state of New Jersey, which is where he lives, because he lives in New Jersey. However, up till very recently, Oz has been a moderate Republican, vocally supporting progressive causes, like gay marriage and abortion rights. But recently, Oz announced his candidacy for Senate and secured an endorsement from Donald Trump. And, as he's done so often in the past, Oz is pushing the beliefs that make him the most amount of money. Despite being vocally pro-choice as recently as 2019, Oz now supports the overturning of Roe v. Wade. Despite authoring a 2017 article touting climate change as a major problem, Oz now downplays the effects of it. Despite lauding Anthony Fauci as a pro at the start of the pandemic, Oz now refers to him as a tyrant. Several times, Oz called for universal healthcare, and was even featured in an advertisement for the Affordable Care Act. Now, Oz promises that he'll vote to repeal it. Oz has repeatedly talked about how pro-LGBTQ he is, and on his show, he offered support to transgender youth and their families. Now, of course, he supports legislation to ban transgender youth from sports. In 2017, Oz advocated for waiting periods for gun purchases. In 2018, he said that gun violence was a public health problem. In 2019, he co-wrote a column urging Americans to ban assault rifles. And now, of course, he dishonestly paints himself as a gun rights advocate. Do you see a pattern? Oz doesn't have viewpoints. He has talking points, which can seemingly be purchased by the highest bidder. And how much do they cost? Oh, they're expensive. Oz's FEC financial disclosures listed his net worth at up to $500 million. And it's not just who pays for them, it's also where. Oz has worked in New York and lived in New Jersey most of his adult life. He lives in a mansion that he and his wife personally built in Cliffside Park. That's an affluent town on the east coast of New Jersey. Pennsylvania, however, is west of New Jersey. Even without traffic, which is statistically impossible, there is no part of Pennsylvania that is within an hour drive of Cliffside Park, and most of it is hundreds of miles away. So how in the fraudulent weight supplement is Mehmet Oz eligible to run for Senate in Pennsylvania, a state where he does not live, does not work, and does not even visit often? And why isn't he just running for Senate in New Jersey? New Jersey is an extremely blue state, last voting for a Republican for president 34 years ago. And when was the last time New Jersey elected a new Republican senator? 1954. So Oz understood he had no chance at a political career in his home state of New Jersey, especially in Cliffside Park, a suburb of New York City, which is where he lives, because he lives in New Jersey, where he built his mansion over 20 years ago, in New Jersey. Oz paid taxes in New Jersey, listed his primary residence in New Jersey, contributed to the campaigns of local politicians in New Jersey, and voted in New Jersey. Until, of course, it benefited him to pretend otherwise. In 2020, Oz changed his voter registration address to his in-laws' house in Pennsylvania, and illegally voted in Pennsylvania elections, despite not living there. Oz's team tells it differently, of course. When asked about Oz allegedly committing a federal offense, a campaign spokesperson had quite the telling response. Dr. Oz lives in Pennsylvania, votes in Pennsylvania, and has his medical license in Pennsylvania. Dr. Oz grew up in the greater Philadelphia region, less than 5 miles from the Pennsylvania border. He went to school in Pennsylvania, met his wife and got married in Pennsylvania, and two of his children were born in Pennsylvania. He currently resides in Bryn Athyn, Pennsylvania, where his wife's family has lived for 100 years. And to that I say, total bullshit. Let's break down that answer. He lives in Pennsylvania? False. There are hundreds of articles over the last 2 decades documenting his residency in New Jersey, including a dedicated profile in People magazine in February of 2020 about his Cliffside home. The article talks about how Oz's children grew up there, and Oz himself discusses his daily commute to New York City from the home. He votes in Pennsylvania? False. Until 2020. Gee, I wonder why Oz would suddenly change his registration from a solidly blue state to a swing state in 2020. Can't think of a reason. He has his medical license in Pennsylvania? Yes, that's true, but that's because that's where he went to school 36 years ago. I went to college in New York. Columbia, actually. The school that should have fired Oz. But unless you still live in on-campus housing, your degree does not determine your residency. Unlike Mehmet Oz, I actually live in Pennsylvania, and where I went to school does not influence that. He grew up in the Philadelphia region, less than 5 miles from the Pennsylvania border. First of all, it's fewer, you idiot. Second, do you know what it's called when you live near Philadelphia, less than 5 miles from the border? It's called New Jersey. He went to school in Pennsylvania. Yes, and also Massachusetts and Delaware. Met his wife and got married in Pennsylvania. Yes, and then they shortly moved to New Jersey. Two of his children were born in Pennsylvania. Yes, and one wasn't. And all three were raised in New Jersey. He currently resides in Bryn Athyn, Pennsylvania. Oh, does he? Because his primary residence is still the home that he built in New Jersey, and where his wife's family has lived for 100 years? A, where your in-laws live does not determine where you live. B, if where your family lives determines where you live, then Oz lives in Turkey. That is where he spent his summers growing up, and where he served 2 years in the Turkish army. Yes, Mehmet Oz doesn't just not live in Pennsylvania. He's actually a Turkish citizen who served a foreign government's military. So, no, Mehmet Oz is not a Pennsylvanian. There were so many lies and misleading misdirections in that statement that I thought Oz was trying to sell me weight loss supplements. To run for Senate, it is a legal requirement that you live in the state in which you are running. And voting from a false address is a violation of U.S. Code 2511. Punishable by up to 5 years in prison. Unless, of course, you're worth $500 million. When you're worth that much, it's also pretty difficult to prosecute you for false claims, or fire you from a professorship. Speaking of which, Oprah, if you are watching, and I'm sure you are, I've heard you're a big fan, please speak out against this carnival-barking huckster. Mehmet Oz represents the opposite of everything you believe in, and you know how much damage he has done under your banner. Oprah, you can fix this. Apologize for unleashing the plague of Mehmet Oz into the world. We can talk about Dr. Phil another time. Unlike Mehmet Oz, I actually live and legally vote in Pennsylvania. Or as Oz's team might call it, just over the border from Ohio. As a Pennsylvanian, I will happily vote against this Spider-Man villain in November. I will be voting against Mehmet Oz for all the desperate people he took advantage of by hawking alleged miracle cures. I will be voting against Dr. Oz for all of the LGBTQ people, all of the women, and all of the gun violence victims that he said he supported until it became financially inconvenient. And I will be voting against Mehmet Oz for the 1.5 million children whose lives he so cavalierly viewed as an inconvenient statistic. I will be voting against Mehmet Oz with two things he used to be familiar with. Because I will be supporting John Fetterman over Mehmet Oz with all of my heart and all of my lungs. Mehmet Oz makes me embarrassed to have a degree from Columbia, and I'll be damned if he also makes me embarrassed to be a Pennsylvanian. Thanks for watching. This was for the smart people. Thank you for watching, following, subscribing, and sharing these videos. If you don't yet, make sure you follow me on TikTok, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and everything else. And of course, Patreon, where you can see videos like this before anyone, and one video a week, exclusively on Patreon. Patreon.com/Steve Hofstetter. I'm back touring again, and I'm performing just about everywhere. All over America, Canada, Europe, Australia, New Zealand, everywhere. Okay, that's not everywhere, but it's a lot of places. Get your tickets and find out more at SteveHofstetter.com.